This is the Canon EOS R5 mirrorless camera. And this is footage I captured at a church this morning. My name is Jake Goslin from churchfront.com, helping you lead gospel-centered and tech-savvy worship. If you haven't already, make sure you do subscribe to the channel and hit that thumbs up button if you enjoyed watching some of the beautiful footage from this camera. A big thanks to Matt from Canon for letting me get my hands on this EOS R5. I also was able to borrow an EOS R6 from Matt a couple weeks ago when we went to Bethel, so I'll link that video right here if you want to check that out. But today is all about the big brother to the R6, the R5. And the R5 has gotten much more of the spotlight for the past few weeks, for better and for worse, because this is an amazing and very capable camera when it comes to both photo and video. Except, of course, there is the controversy surrounding the overheating issues. If you guys watched the R6 review video, you saw how we couldn't shoot in 4K for much longer than 25 minutes until we dealt with the overheating issue. I'm glad to report, though, that on this camera, there's a 4K lower quality codec that doesn't give you overheating issues. You're only limited by the 29 to 30 minute limitation they put on DSLR cameras. And that's not because of overheating, that's just because they don't want to be a true video camera. My first impression of this camera is that it is incredible. I didn't even take time to capture an 8K RAW because I have no reason to do that, but it can do that, which is amazing. Of course, there's gonna be the time limitations. I would use this camera primarily for capturing short form video as well as stills. I think it can work out really well in that type of environment, especially when we're talking about churches. Maybe your church creative department is looking for a camera that can do it all in terms of phenomenal photos of your Sunday morning worship and other events at your church. And then maybe you want a camera that can also shoot some interviews and do some other creative video projects during the week. I don't think this is a great camera for a broadcast video environment for doing live streaming at your church. Not to say it's not impossible to do with this camera, but I feel like it's making it do something that it wasn't intended to do. I don't know about the overheating issues, whether or not that plays a role if you're just pulling an HDMI output from the camera and going into your switcher and not actually recording to the sensor. My guess is that it shouldn't have a factor as long as you make sure that the auto sleep is turned off on this camera and you're not actually recording. It's not gonna like stop your video feed, but I would check that yourself. When it comes to the ports on this camera, it only gives you one of those micro HDMI outs. Not a huge fan of that. I like it when cameras have the full HDMI out. But of course, we got other ports here as well. Our 3.5 millimeter jack for a microphone, a headphone jack, a USB cable to plug it into your computer. Now that I've had my hands both on the R6 and the R5, I really think the intention here from Canon was to mostly catch up with the competition out there in the mirrorless market, especially Sony with their new camera that just came out. You don't have any of those overheating record limitations with the Sony a7S III. So let's talk about what I really love about this camera, especially in a worship church environment. And keep in mind, I'm not really talking about using this for a live streaming camera. I think it's gonna be better for just like a creative project camera, making videos like promo videos for your churches. You're gonna wanna be able to capture great interviews. You're gonna wanna capture great B-roll footage. I think this camera can do awesome at that, especially when it comes to the B-roll footage, having the ability to have 4K at 120 frames per second. You can just handhold this guy all day long, especially with the in-body stabilization. Check out some of this footage here where I was able to literally just like, I was running almost like we're walking very aggressively, doing this kind of orbit effect around this worship leader in this shot here. And it's amazing how much between the stabilization and the 4K 120, it really smooths out the final image. So that's one reason I think this is very powerful for creative videography. And then of course with Canon, you do have the color. Of course you can shoot in C-Log, have a really high dynamic range for a mirrorless camera. You got the Canon's autofocus as well. So those things you guys are probably familiar with if you are at all familiar with Canon cameras. And here are some of the stills I took with this camera. I'm not a super pro photographer. I just like to put it in aperture priority mode so I can set that bokeh in the background and then let the camera do its thing. And it is really great for capturing stills of a worship service environment. In the end, I really think Canon has designed an amazing mirrorless camera. It's really catching up to the competition with Sony as well as Panasonic has the S1H out. I think that's a pretty underrated camera. Canon is it's catching up. It was funny, this camera came out at the beginning of July and there's so much hype around it. It's like, oh, this is like the best camera in the world. And then a couple days ago, the Sony A7S III was released and that thing is a beast, especially because it can do pretty much everything this camera does without the overheating limitations. So if you're shopping for a camera that can do both stills and video very well, make sure you compare this camera with the Sony full frame A7S III. And if you're like many churches looking for video cameras that are true video cameras, I would consider looking into the C200, which I have right here filming the side angle, or the C300 Mark III that just came out. It's definitely pricier. It's probably overkill for a lot of churches. That's why I'd say the C200 could be a really great broadcast camera as well as a great dedicated video camera for other creative projects your church may be doing throughout the week. Does this camera live up to all the hype? Of course it does. I'm blown away by the stabilization and the high frame rates you can now shoot in with something like this. It really performs well in low light. I can crank the ISO up quite a bit without introducing any noise or grain into the image. And when it came to the overheating, I'm so glad that you can at least shoot in a 4K mode without worrying about overheating. If you shoot in the high quality 4K mode where it actually downsamples from 8K down to 4K, that's when you're gonna have those time limitations. And you'll also have a time limitation when you're shooting in 4K 120. So is this the best all-in-one video and stills camera? I think only time will tell, especially once we see some of the competition come out, like this new Sony A7S III. Again, the overheating, it's kind of a big deal. It wasn't a huge deal because I was shooting for about 2 hours this morning. I only needed about 20 minutes of high frame rate footage, but when it wasn't there anymore and I would had to have put my camera in the refrigerator, that's pretty annoying. So for a true video camera from Canon, with all the benefits of Canon, the high frame rates, 4K 120, as well as the high dynamic range and the autofocus, you'll have to go with a C300 Mark III, especially if you want the 4K 120, or if you're okay with 4K 60, you can go with the C200. So great job, Canon. I wish the overheating thing wasn't an issue, but it is. But it's a great step in the right direction. So I don't want to either encourage you or discourage you guys to pick this up. You're gonna have to do the research, consider the context of your ministry for yourself, because you can only determine whether or not it's gonna be the right fit for you. I always wanna give the caveat though with these cameras, the R6 and the R5, if you are doing long form video, I would not encourage you to get these. Get the higher end cinema cameras. Or for a more budget friendly route, you can explore cameras by Blackmagic or Panasonic. So that's all I have for you in this video today. Best of luck as you make your camera buying decisions. And I don't think you'll be unhappy with this camera. Just understand its limitations. If you found this video helpful, smash that thumbs up button and share it with your friends in ministry. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on any of our latest videos to help you grow yourself and grow your church.